So talk us through first and foremost. We've got Samsung, SK Hynix, of course, basically Asian players winning contracts with OpenAI and Stargate. But this is as the leadership in Washington are really pushing for more domestic manufacturing. Just talk us through it.
Well, when you think about it, you have to look at it in the broader AI context. And for the Trump administration, this would certainly support their goal of propelling investment in Stargate, in OpenAI, in that big data center project that the president heralded at the beginning of his term. But there were a few questions left unanswered. One is the price tag. And will this help support what is part of a trade deal with South Korea that calls for as much as $350 billion in South Korean investment in the U.S. over the next several years? Also left unanswered is where all of this high bandwidth memory is going to be produced, Caro. We don't know whether this is going to be made in Asia or if they may try to do some of this production in the U.S. And that is certainly a goal of the U.S. and of the Trump administration to onshore more of that chip production. And so there may be more pressure from the administration on these two companies, on the government in Seoul, to try to make some more of that happen.
Shep, another headline out of D.C. Trump's proposed changes to visa rules assailed by the chip industry. What's the team been reporting on here?
Well, this is another cross current that we're seeing here in Washington, and that is namely that for all of the push on getting manufacturing onshored here, there is a tension over the workforce. And we have heard administration officials talk about trying to develop the workforce. But the industry has outlined a major challenge, and that is simply that the country is not producing enough graduates here in the U.S. to meet the potential demand of all of that manufacturing and data center and AI expansion that is projected to happen over the next 5 years. There is an estimated 67,000 job gap, according to the semiconductor makers. Now, what we're seeing is pushback from chip makers against an administration plan to crack down on the F-1 student visa. This is a key pipeline for talent in the tech industry. It is something that they have relied on for years. Students currently are able to stay for an indefinite period, as long as they're actively in a course of study. But the administration wants to shorten that to 4 years. And industry is saying, look, a less friendly approach to immigration will drive away talent to other countries that are more welcoming, and it will hurt competition. One CEO wrote in, an unnamed chief executive from a semiconductor company wrote in to say that they were deeply troubled to see this and that it will harm competitiveness for the industry here in the U.S. And this comes as also the administration is raising the fee for H-1B visas to $100,000 for new applications. And for chip companies, that could mean hundreds of millions of dollars in additional fees trying to get all that talent here in the U.S. to meet this demand that they have for jobs.